people still go to YouTube for certain shows, millions and millions of views that advertisers would pay for, just as if those views were on television. It's the same view.
My kid ain't going to be no YouTube
it's
star.
It's fine.
It is fine. And it does
but
take a lot of
work. But you'd be proud of a show that she created, just like you created a show. You'd be proud of a kid that put her show on YouTube and built her brand that way.
For sure.
And that's
using the platform to showcase your art.
Well, I think good and bad.
Thing.
Any platform. Twitch has some pretty bad, gnarly stuff that I will never, you know, go down that hole.
What do you mean?
I've seen some stuff on Twitch that I'm just like, yeah, I'm not going to watch that.
What? I only know it for like video games.
Yes,
and shit.
Well, just like it's turning into YouTube. It's trying to be its own YouTube, which means they're embracing all different types of content. So when you start to see, certain Twitch stars are girls showing nudity, just like Instagram's becoming. You go to Instagram, girls are building their Instagram followers that way through using sex. That's fine, totally. But, and so Twitch is using that.
Oh, so Twitch has naked chicks on it now?
Yeah, I'm starting to see it on there.
And you can be naked?
Yeah.
I didn't know this.
I think so. I'm not sure. You're a Twitcher yourself. I'm thinking about becoming a Twitcher.
Right.
And it just reminds me of the platform Live Me, which remember the platform that I was on.
I do.
And there were some inappropriate things that people would be doing to build up money and build up likes because we're human beings. We're going to choose things, different things that.
And you mean inappropriate, like jerking off or.
Which is fine. Do it. I don't care. Right. But I'm not going to watch it.
Oh, so there's naked chicks on Twitter. Are they video? Are they playing games?
I think Twitter's got some rules.
No, Twitch.
And Twitch, I think, is probably going to start to set
By the way,
rules.
Twitter ain't got no rules.
But like,
I've been scrolling
through and
see some
shit. You can be a gamer and just dress scantily while you play games. You're making money the same way as if you are on Instagram taking scantily pictures, which is fine. Totally do that. But that's why people want to do that. That's easy. That's fun. People like the excitement of that.
Maybe I should Twitch naked.
I think there
probably wouldn't be helpful to my
Twitch
views.
Scantily clad.
So should I scantily clad my
like
next
a Speedo,
Twitch?
Show off all your tattoos. Give them a preview of that. Like put it in like a
should
black
I go
and white.
Topless for
can
the
you
rest
filter,
of the Twitch?
Can you filter your Twitch stream? Can you put like a black and white filter so it's like, you know, noir, like you naked, just like, yeah. Here you
great.
Go.
Great. So I'm going to Twitch the rest of the show topless. You think this is going to help the views?
No.
I don't think it's going to help the views at all.
You're a man.
Well, I'm that fat
if
old.
I would argue if it was a woman.
Look at this fucking thirst trap over here on Twitch. There you go. All right. So this is potentially helping us grow views.
Potentially. Twitch does not have a problem with it.
They don't have a problem with me being.
And I think they wouldn't.
We're getting
it's
please don't.
Capitalism.
We're getting please
you
don't.
Do what you want.
I'll do whatever the fuck I want on my Twitch.
I don't think you could jerk it. I think they would put that as inappropriate content. And maybe there's a version of Twitch where they show you the inappropriate comment. I'm not sure about the Twitch platform. I'm just reading about it. Thinking about starting my own. Thinking about going to get NBA 2K and stream. Myself
now, can I have my cock out right now?
No, I think that would make your content explicit, and I would assume that Twitch would have the wherewithal to put that video in a section and mark your show
mature. Now, if I just crossed over into the mature look right now?
No, you're still cable appropriate.
Even what if I'm a girl?
No.
So if I'm a girl,
explicit.
It's explicit.
Currently in the way...
Because the way we all have decided society is with boobs.
Correct.
Because my boobs are gross. I mean...
No, you are turning some ladies on, definitely. And
no
maybe
chance.
Some men.
No chance.
Yeah.
I am not turning anybody on.
You are.
I am not. I'm looking at it. By the way, the views have spiked up.
Gone up.
I mean, you know, I don't know what to tell you. There's maybe a lot of people out there, daddyissues.com.
How about
I don't
this?
Know what to tell
they
you.
See, like, if someone was, if somebody shared you like that, that engages people. So that's, it's the nudity that brings people in. We're just trying to do
listen,
crazy
I got
things.
No problem doing this shit with my shirt off every day if it's going to help the fucking views. Are you kidding me?
My Jennifer loves this show on YouTube. I don't know what it's called. It's this guy, Shane Dawson, does this show. Have you ever heard of this guy?
I feel like, he was the first, the first podcaster. This guy was huge, I think.
He still is pretty massive. And so he does a YouTube show that has millions of views.
Right.
And she, my girlfriend, loves his show.
What's this guy do?
He does like the
Does he take his shirt off?
No.
Okay.
No, he does.
He's gay, right?
He is gay.
Okay.
He does a documentary sort of, the ones I've watched, again, I've watched maybe three episodes of this guy's show. And it's a documentary style type of documenting YouTube stars. Like he did a documentary on Jake Paul and all the stuff he was doing. And it's just him with a camera.
Got it.
Close to his face. Okay. It's a certain type of filmmaking.
Sure.
With jump cuts. Close to the face.
Right.
Jump cuts. And that's what people, that's what his audience loves. And he does great. You could say it's journalism. He's interviewing. He interviewed Jake Paul. He interviewed Jake Paul's girlfriend. They're getting into
Aren't
why.
Aren't those the, like the worst creeps ever? Is that the creep
Again,
who did the suicide
China
thing?
And that's what
thing.
Shane Dawson does. He tries to show you and be transparent with how these people are acting. Get sides from everyone in that story. I learned about the whole Team 10 thing, which was Jake Paul's like collective of YouTube stars and what he was doing to them. There were people that were, you know, trying to sue him and say he was, you know, belittling them. But it's like, you signed up.
Right. So it was Shane Dawson having these people's backs.
No, he doesn't have a side. He kind of has a side of like what's
like investigative reporting for YouTubers.
And people like him, people have formed a one-way friendship with him. I've actually met him. He's come into the restaurant before. He's so nice, and I had no idea, and I've watched his show now a couple times. The next time he comes in, I'll be like, hey man, I really love your show, it's really good.
And this is but Shane Dawson.
People and I remember people have come up to him while he's been at the restaurant being like, I really really like your show.
Got it.
Like,
all right, well maybe I'll watch his shit.
You should. He's really good. He's coming out with his own makeup line, working with Jeffree Star. You know Jeffree Star?
I don't.
You don't know Jeffree Star?
I don't think so.
Yeah, that's
like, go to Vangerville.
9.18 million followers, Shane Dawson.
That's a lot.
YouTube star, number one. That's a wraparound. Thought there was only one Shane. There's actually two Shane.
I think we're the second thing that comes up. It's Shane Dawson and then us.
Oh,
we're
nice.
Like the third thing on, yeah.
See if I can get, I'll ask him to come on this show. I'm sure that would be a massive win.
That would be big.
Yeah, because he's got lots of views.
That would be huge for us.
The viewers of his show would like our show. Saying it right now.
So the next time he's at the restaurant, you should say, listen, man, come do the podcast.
I don't do that. I think that's cheese.
You think it's cheese to ask people to come on the show?
In that I don't know. That's
yeah,
like a,
for sure.
My first meeting of them.
No,
they come to this.
No,
I'm representing the restaurant.
You shouldn't do that.
Hey, can I get you guys a glass of wine? Also, I have a really great podcast.
No, that would be bad. Don't act like
that. I know
that.
You're like an Oscar winner, but have you ever been on a podcast?
Hey, what Oscar winner?
Oh, Oscar winners coming through the restaurant all the time. I love when you get an Oscar winner sitting at one area. They can see the door. Then another Oscar winner strolls in. And even though those Oscar winners maybe don't know each other, there's like this connection.
Oh, no, they got that weird thing.
And they look and there's like a acknowledgement that you're both
in
massive and
in
uber.
The club. You're in the club.
You're in the club.
You're in the Oscar club.
You're in the Oscar
That's
club.
That's fair.
That's totally fair.
100%.
When I see other podcasters, I'm like, hey.
Gotcha.
You and I. You were a TV host. Now you're trying to be a podcaster. We're the same.
Exactly.
Every time the NFL Network people come in, I like want to send them stuff and be like, I love the NFL, but I keep composure.
We got a really good compliment the other day. A friend of mine who was like a thing was like, man, it is unbelievable that you guys have the listenership you have. And it's not at all based on who you have coming in. Like these podcasts, it's always about what famous guy they got. It's never about that
the
for us.
The podcasting world is guests. Get
that's it.
Guests.
Fame.
To the point now where Joe Rogan brings on, I've never heard of this guy, but they're coming for Rogan, right? He always has a guest. I don't listen to that show. I don't listen to podcasts too much.
I don't either. I have no interest in listening to podcasts, which is a little weird. But there's nobody I want to talk. There's nobody I want to listen to more than me and the sound of my own voice.
Right.
I think we're very good at this. No, right. I think we're incredibly good at this now. And when I start listening to other people, I'm like, man, you guys are shitty. I tried listening to that Bob Menery podcast for 3 minutes. It was fucking terrible. Awful. Dude's getting millions of listens. He's that crazy Instagram star. He's the guy that interviewed. Anyway, let's get into Vangerville.
currently at our restaurant.
Losing viewers.
Oh, you peaked for a second. Peaked. They saw you were naked. They saw you're not doing anything really interesting.
For sure.
You're just talking. But and you now you're just sitting
my,
there.
You don't know what's in my lap. Go ahead.
Have you ever seen grumpy old men?
Yeah, I live grumpy old men. What are you talking about?
There's just a scene in Grumpy Old Men where Jack Lemmon is naked, right? Getting right. That just for some reason. Deja vu. So I'm comparing you to Jack Lemmon.
That's great.
No, that's a joke. It was a joke.
I'm teasing.
No, you're getting upset.
No,
I see it.
I'm very fine it with my. I'm very fine.
I know
with my
you are. I wish I had your tattoos. They're so cool.
They are.
At the restaurant.
Yeah. Well, no, you got to give me a minute to recover.
I think you just told me
grumpy old men and Jack Lemmon's naked
joke.
Body when you're looking at my body on the thing.
I don't have my glasses on, and I could just see the video, and I'm sorry, okay? It was a joke. I thought we were comfortable
like Jack Lemmon.
Enough with each other to make the joke. I feel like you're friends
you can't
that
shame
were listening.
Me.
I can't. I'm sorry.
You can't body shame me. I won't let you.
I'm not. Body, I was a joke.
I won't let
and
you.
I feel bad now that I made the joke.
Don't.
Can I take it
don't
back?
Don't feel bad. It was,
I thought
it
this was a safe space to make
it's coming
jokes.
From an honest place. Don't
no,
take
it's
it
not.
Back.
Please don't.
You
please
just
don't
looked at my body on the screen.
With the statement, it was a joke.
You looked at my
We're
body on the
to
screen.
Joke with each other. In my head, I thought it was funny, and I thought I'd bring it to the show, but now I feel bad.
You looked at my body
I'm
on the screen,
sorry.
And then you brought up a scene in Grumpy Old Men where Jack Lemmon is naked. That's it. That's all. That's all. You can move on. It's fine. I'm just
what can I do to bring it back on track? Because I feel terrible and I apologize.
I'm locked in, man. I'm a professional.
Nope. I apologize to you from the bottom of my heart because you're right. It was a joke that kind of body shamed you, and it's a different time now, and I can't make that Jack Lemmon joke anymore.
Fine. It's also a bad angle. Like, I look better if I'm standing up. I'm looking at my body right
now.
I can't believe
I exist.
Nobody
looks.